With me on the line from Caledonia Mining, I'm joined by Steve Curtis. Steve, good afternoon.
Afternoon, Andrew.
Full year production at Blanket for 2018, Steve, approximately 54, just over 54,500 ounces, so within guidance.
Yes, Andrew, within guidance. Unfortunately, the reduced guidance that we put out due to various circumstances in Zimbabwe. But we're very pleased that we came inside of the range of 54 to 56, and you know we have been able to produce this amount of gold whilst again the Central Shaft project continues. So it's a very, very good effort from the mining guys, and yeah, as usual, our gold production tends to ramp up towards the end of the year, and it's very pleasing to see that the fourth quarter was roughly 7% higher than the previous quarter. So a very good result.
And for 2019, Steve, what guidance have you set yourself production-wise?
We are guiding to the market 53 to 56,000 ounces, and that is a symptom of the fact that we have got the same infrastructure, we've got the same logistical constraints. The Central Shaft project is reaching its finality, but we are still mining in the old section and the new section of the mine. But we've only got four shaft available to us to hoist the ore, and therefore we are not guiding that we will be able to deliver more. Our tons are roughly 1,650 tons a day, which is pretty much the capacity of that shaft, because there will always be development waste. So that's 1,650 of ore, and there will always be development waste that has to come out as well. And that's the constraint that we are saddled with until the new central shaft is out. So yeah, we are targeting 53 to 56. That generates sufficient revenue and free cash flow at the effective budgeted gold price that will enable us to run the mine and generate sufficient cash to be able to spend on CapEx and move this project along, because we are basically in the last 18 months of the project. We've got a busy year this year. We need to spend about $21 million again on capital. At least half of that is on the central shaft. So, we have to make the money to spend the money. But at these guidance ounces, that's all doable.
And you're expecting the shaft sinking will be complete around the middle of the year?
That's correct. We're going to be stopping the shaft at about just over 1,200 metres, 1,204 effectively. Engineers like to be precise. That will enable us then to start equipping immediately, which will take us about a year. It is a huge exercise to equip the shaft 1.2 kilometres deep, and that will then allow the shaft to be ready for commissioning in middle to late of 2020 and make it available to the miners to be able to achieve that target of 80,000 ounces by during 2021. Since we developed this life of mine plan in late 2014 and embarked on the Central Shaft project in early 2015, at that point in time we had a six-year life of mine. So we have moved on 4 years, and we're sitting today, due to extensive exploration at the Blanket mine and the various ore bodies that make up the Blanket mine, deep drilling, exploration as we've gone deeper and deeper into the mine, and we've had access to drill cubbies. We're now sitting 4 years since we put this whole plan together, where we decided to sink a shaft and develop a new mine. We're now sitting with a 14-year life of mine, and we nearly have a shaft completed and the new mine ready to go into operation. So that's a very, very good position for us to be in, and it's a great effort from the geological team. So we're very pleased with that. So once this project is completed, the central shaft is done and it's equipped, this mine is not going to be looking at massive capital expenditure for many years to come. Of course, the exploration will continue and the development work will continue to keep the infrastructure developing ahead of the need. And we're very pleased with that. We've got through this process on a fully funded, self-funded basis. So it's a very, very good effort from our engineering team.
Of course, currency is still an ongoing issue in Zimbabwe. How are you coping?
Yeah, Andrew, we can't deny that currency, foreign currency in Zimbabwe is a major, major problem. It's a problem for us, and it's a major problem for the country as a whole. But as a generator of foreign currency, we are in a fairly small group of companies and businesses in Zimbabwe. And the mere fact that we have been able to produce 54,500 ounces last year, which took access to foreign currency for consumables into account, we've been able to do that, which is evidence that we had access to foreign currency because we generate foreign currency. We've also been able to advance the Central Shaft project, which has got a major foreign currency component in terms of its capital expenditure needs. And again, that is evidence that because we're a generator of foreign currency, we've had access to foreign currency. And we are very pleased that we've been able to remit excess money out of Zimbabwe, being our share of dividends declared by Blanket. And we have received our dividends, and we've been able to remit those up to our Jersey Holding Company. And that's enabled the Jersey Holding Company to be able to happily continue to declare the dividends. And we've just declared a dividend for the first quarter of 2019. And again, that is evidence that it is very tough, but you can do business under these circumstances if you're a generator of foreign currency. And we continue to be a generator, and our ambition is to be a bigger and bigger generator of foreign currency and to contribute to the economy and obviously contribute to the growth of Caledonia in its own right.
Tell me a little bit more about these hedging contracts you've entered into, Steve.
Towards the end of last year, we were talking amongst ourselves and saying, you know, at a point in time, if the gold price does a bit of a run on us, and there were indications that there was an opportunity for gold to get a little bit of a head of steam, and we believe it's prudent that in an environment like Zimbabwe, where we are running a self-funded project, we're in the last 18 months, as I say. And we've got a total capex bill of about 21 million. Obviously, not all of that is foreign currency denominated, but a large proportion of it is foreign currency denominated, because the central shaft costs when you get into equipping are very foreign currency heavily weighted. So we believed it was prudent to protect the downside from any gold price movement, and that we would have sufficient revenue from our gold production to enable this project to be completed. Our CapEx project is heavily weighted in the first half of the year versus the second half of the year, because as we said, we would be completing the sink by the sort of the mid part of the year, which has got a cost component. But then we would need to purchase all of the steel and the ancillary materials that would be necessary for equipping well in advance of actually getting to that final sink stage. So we've got a large foreign currency need in the first quarter. We wanted to make sure that whatever happened in the gold markets, we would produce as to our budget, and we wanted to protect the gold price on the downside. So we took these put options at 1250, which will put us in a very comfortable position based on our own internal forecasts of what our cash flow needs are. That beats our budgeting parameters. So we're comfortable taking these put options at 1250 for the next 5 months. on about 22,500 ounces of gold. And we'll review this on an ongoing basis, depending on what the gold price does. But this gives us a feeling of comfort that the revenue is going to be in the bag as long as the production guys deliver the gold and do what they've signed up for.
Great to speak with you, Steve. Thanks for your time.
My pleasure. Andrew, thank you for the opportunity.